All right, we'll continue from the morning class. Maybe some people had to join, but I think we can proceed. Actually, in inverse trigonometry, let us say I have sine inverse 3 by 5. I can even write this as cos inverse 4 by 5. I can even write this as tan inverse 3 by 4. One inverse can be converted into another inverse. Why? Let's say I have a rectangle triangle. This is theta, this is 3, and this is 4, and this is 5. Sine theta is 3 by 5, cos theta is 4 by 5, and tan theta is 3 by 4. So same theta, I can write tan inverse 3 by 5. I can write cos inverse 4 by 5. I can write tan inverse 3 by 4. You may be using in physics, all these are like 37 degrees or something like that. Right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So one inverse can be converted into another inverse. So it is not a big deal. For example, if somebody asks you cos of sine inverse 3 by 5. Yeah, cos and sine cannot be cancelled. But if you have cos and cos inverse, they can be cancelled. So you can write cos of cos inverse instead of 3 by 5. You can write 4 by 5. And you can cancel and say answer is 4 by 5. Another way of saying is somebody can take this as theta. Let sine inverse 3 by 5 is theta. From that you will get sine theta is 3 by 5. But we don't want to, if this is theta, our question is cos theta. If sine theta is 3 by 5, what is cos theta? It will be 4 by 5. One may say it may be plus or minus. No, it is only plus because sine inverse of a positive number will give answer only between 0 to 90. And if something is between 0 to 90, cos is positive. Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we are going to write something like something. I don't want to call them formulas. Okay? Don't want to remember them or by heart them. But we can use those techniques. Okay, or at least you should know that one inverse trigonometric function can be converted into another trigonometric function. For that, I am stating this formulas kind of thing. Let us say this is a right angle triangle. I want to take x here, 1 here, and this is a theta, and this is root 1 plus x square. From this figure, and I also want to take right in the beginning, let x is greater than 0. Sine inverse x, because okay, maybe let me give you more clarity here. Okay, what is x? We'll define it, but let us talk about sine inverse x. From this figure, I can also write this as cos inverse. Is it sine inverse x? Sorry, something wrong. It is tan inverse x. Let me write 1 here and root 1 minus x square here. Yes. Sine inverse x is equal to cos inverse root 1 minus x square. It is also equal to tan inverse x by root 1 minus x square. You can also write this as cosecant inverse 1 by x.
You can also write this as bit blur, sir.
My video is blur. What about for others?
No, sir, it's clear, sir.
Yes,
clear, sir.
Clear, sir.
Okay. Sir, then it clear, will be my network issue.
Okay. Wait for some time or you rejoin. If it still persists, then just you can later on see the recording or something. Secant inverse yes. 1 by root 1 minus x square and cot inverse root over 1 minus x square by x. All these are from one figure only, because if I take sine theta, I'll get x. If I take cos theta, I'll get this by this. If I take tan theta, I'll get this by this. Okay, so one inverse can be converted into another inverse. So sine inverse, how to convert into other inverses I gave. But I want to write here only 0 less than x less than 1. Because when x is negative, this will give me an answer in negative degrees or angle in negative. But cos inverse of something cannot give an angle in negative form. Okay, it only gives between 0 to pi. Okay, so that is the reason I'm mentioning here. Okay, when I equate these two, x can be negative also. I'll mention this formula separately. But in now, what I'm talking about is how to convert one inverse into another inverse. Once again, I'm not saying you by heart this. I can, if somebody asks me sine inverse of 5 by 13 is equal to cos inverse what, I'm not going to use this formula. I know I can draw a rectangle triangle. I can call this as theta. Sine theta is 5 by 13 is 5 is opposite side. 13 is hypotenuse. So 12 is adjacent side. So cos inverse, what will come here?
12 by 13.
12 by 13. Okay. So I'm going to directly write 12 by 13. If somebody would have asked me cot inverse, convert sine inverse into cot inverse. Okay. Then what is cot theta here? 12
by
5.
12
by 5.
5. Yeah. Okay, so the point I want to convey is that, but just for the sake of writing in notes, I'm giving this like this. Okay, almost same. Somebody can start with tan inverse x if they want to take a right angle triangle. This is some theta x and 1 is here and this is root 1 plus x square. And here x can be any positive number. X greater than 0, that's sufficient. Tan inverse x can be written as sine inverse x by root 1 plus x square. Cos inverse 1 by root 1 plus x square. This is equal to cot inverse x. That is also equal to cosecant inverse root 1 plus x square by x. That is also equal to secant inverse root 1 plus x square. All are just from the triangle one. I equated this to theta. I got tan theta equal to x, means opposite side is x and adjacent side is 1. Constructed the triangle and then any ratios they want, I can tell. We start with sine inverse, tan inverse, then cos inverse. This is x and this is 1 and this is a root 1 plus x square. No, sorry. This is 1 and this is root 1 minus x square. As well, here also I should write 0 less than x less than 1. Cos inverse x is sine inverse root 1 minus x square.
Sir, in second one, that is cot inverse 1 by x, second one.
Oh, yeah, thank you. This is cot inverse 1 by x, okay, not x. This is tan inverse root 1 minus x square by x. And then secant inverse 1 by x. And cosecant inverse 1 by root 1 minus x square. And cot inverse x by root 1 minus x square. So you can start with any inverse and convert into any inverse you want. That's the point. Here I did not write 1, but at 1 actually these two are also equal. But I removed 1 because here denominator should not be 0 for that reason. While equating these two, I can put an equality here also. I can put an equality here also. But for all of them to be equal, they should be defined. I have, that's why I write open 0 and open 1. Okay, I'm not going to write 3 more formulas. It is not that I have to write cosecant inverse x and write all that. They are also included here. So three sufficient. Okay, I'm going to erase these things. Anybody needs more time?
Sir, 1 minute.
Okay. So don't run the third point, sir. Remaining ones should up, sir.
Okay.
Finish, sir.
Okay. I may be writing 1, 2, 3 many times, so I'm not giving any side heading as such. If you want, you can call section 1, section 2, section 3 or something. Okay. Once again, I'm starting with 1. Sine inverse x is same as cosecant inverse 1/x. Doesn't matter whether x is negative or positive. Okay. That is a very simple thing. Whether I ask sine inverse 1/2 or cosecant inverse 2, both are same, right? 30 degrees. Okay, so if sine theta is x, obviously cosecant theta is 1/x. So if you take this theta, you can write sine inverse x. If you take this theta, you can write cosecant inverse 1/x. You don't need any proof for this as such. Writing this sufficient. Sine theta is equal to x implies cosecant theta equal to x. So theta is equal to sine inverse x and also cosecant inverse 1 minus x. So you don't need any proof. But anybody want to tell me for what x value this statement is correct? Can I take x equal to 2?
For x not equal to 0.
0.
Can I take x equal to 2?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. 0 is, yeah, 0 should not be there because it should be defined. That's correct.
X lies between minus 1 to plus 1.
Yeah, except 0. For all x belongs to closed interval minus 1 to 1 except 0. Let us say I want to write same thing in a different way. I want to write cosecant inverse x is equal to sine inverse 1/x. Both carry same meaning, but there is a slight difference. Here what x values are okay?
Minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to infinity.
Yes, that is the domain of cosecant inverse. So it is for all x belongs to minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to infinity. Okay. Cos inverse x, I can write secant inverse x 1/x. Again, same thing for all x belongs to minus 1 to 1 except 0. And secant inverse x, you can write cos inverse 1/x for all x belongs to minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to infinity. Tan inverse x, I can write cot inverse 1/x. Anybody want to say for what x values it is okay? When is tan inverse x and cot inverse 1/x are equal?
All real numbers except
0. All real numbers except 0. Anybody want to tell anything
x
else?
X not equals to mpi by 2. X not equals to mpi by 2.
Here x is not an angle, man. If I talk about tan x, x is an angle. I am not going to put any mpi by 2 here. Okay. I'll tell you what you are saying is correct when I say tan x is equal to 1 by cot x when it is true. That time you can say something of that sort. Okay. Anybody else want to say anything else?
X greater than 0.
Yeah, that's good, K. Divya. It is very, very important to remember for negative values, there is a problem tan versus cot, especially about the what you call principal values. Luckily for sine and cosecant, both have same principal values, minus pi by 2, pi by 2. Maybe 0 is not included. That's the only difference. Cos and secant have same principal values, 0 to pi, except pi by 2 maybe. But tan and cot not like that. Tan principal values are minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, whereas cot principal values are 0 to pi. So if I give tan inverse 1 by root 3 and cot inverse root 3, no problem. This is also 30, that's also 30. But if I give tan inverse minus 1 by root 3, cot inverse minus root 3, what is this value? First one. Tan inverse minus 1 by root
3.
Minus 30 degrees. And what about cot inverse minus root 3? 150.
120.
They're not. Yeah. So this is only for x greater than 0 or x belongs to 0 to infinity, not for negative values. Especially because of the principal values that we have problem. Okay, then one may say, I'll agree that is only for positive values. For negative values, is there any formula? Anybody want to comment on that? Tan inverse x will be what when x is negative? It is not cot inverse 1 by x, but what it is?
Pi by 2 minus
cot inverse 1 by x.
What?
Pi minus cot inverse
1
by x.
Pi minus cot inverse 1 by x. That's correct. Because earlier when we got 30 or minus 30, there we got 150. It is not pi minus, sorry, it is pi plus. No, no. Not even that.
Pi by 2 minus.
And that was cot inverse 1 by x minus pi. Sorry. It is cot inverse 1 by x minus pi. Okay. Why is that? Let us take x is equal to minus root 3. Okay. What is this answer? Minus 60. What is this answer? Minus 120. Am I right? So plus pi. I should write it as just a minute. This is minus 60. This alone is minus 120. I want to make it minus 60. So minus cot inverse x minus pi. Am I right about that? Plus 120. Yeah. This is minus cot inverse 1 by x minus pi. That mean this to write it. Sorry. Minus cot inverse 1 by x minus pi. Let us see why. If I take x equal to minus 1, a simple example, this is minus 45. This without minus 135, with minus it is minus 135. No? Then, sorry, I was writing something wrong there. Okay. This is 135.
Sir, pi by 2 minus 1 by x.
I have to remove from pi and then this is 135, pi minus that. Plus pi only, sorry. 1 minute. Pi minus cot inverse 1 by x, and I should put a minus to that. So minus pi plus cot inverse. So I was writing correct this one. Sorry, earlier what I wrote fine. So when I put x equal to minus 1, this is minus 45. This is 135. This is minus 180. It's fine, right? Let's say I put x is equal to minus 1 by root 3. This is minus 30. That is 150, this is minus 150, minus 180, minus 30. Is it okay now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Anyway, we'll prove it thoroughly. It's not that we'll take some examples. It's easy to prove it. I'll tell you how to prove it. This is for all x belongs to minus infinity to 0. Okay. So how to prove this? Let tan inverse x equal to theta. Since x less than 0, theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to 0. Whenever x is negative, the answer for this will be between minus 90 to 0. Okay, now I'll get x is equal to tan theta. I'll get 1 by x is equal to cot theta. Now I want to talk about cot inverse 1 by x, or you can talk about tan inverse, it's okay. Let me start about cot inverse 1 by x. In the place of 1 by x, I can write cot theta. Sorry, cot inverse cot theta. Sorry about it. Cot inverse cot theta. Can I cancel cot inverse and cot and write answer as theta here?
No, sir.
Why it is no?
No, sir.
Because it is fourth quadrant.
Yeah, it is not within the principal values. The principal values for cot are 0 to pi, whereas theta is between minus 90 to 0. Okay, now let us look at a question. If somebody gives you cot inverse cot minus 30, what are you going to do? Or minus 20 degrees?
One eighty minus twenty.
Yeah, you can take minus and then write this 20 as 180 minus 160. Cot 180 minus theta is minus cot 160. You are going to get cot inverse cot 160, and 160 is within the principal values. You can cancel. You'll get 160. Right? The same thing I'm going to do. I'm going to write this as cot inverse cot theta minus pi. Why? What is cot pi minus theta? Plus cot theta or minus cot theta?
Minus cot theta.
So if I want to remove this minus, I can reverse this and write cot theta minus pi is equal to cot theta. One may say, why only this? We can write so many other things. For example, cot inverse, that cot theta, somebody can write cot theta plus 2 pi. Because that is also cot theta only, right? Why I only wrote this is that first point is cot theta minus pi is equal to cot theta. That is the first point. And another important point why I chose that is when theta is between minus 90 to 0, anybody want to tell me theta minus pi is between what to what? Sorry, I don't want to take theta minus pi. I want to take theta plus pi. Sorry about it. Cot 180 plus theta is cot theta, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. But why I chose theta minus pi is also correct. But why I chose theta plus pi is that when theta is between minus 90 to 0, theta plus pi will be between what to what?
Pi by 2 to pi.
Is that part of the principal values for cot?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
because this is within the principal values, I can cancel out and write theta plus pi. Okay, so the reason I changed, just a minute. My son is asking, he knows a little bit of English, first grade. He's asking what is theta means. What can I tell? Okay, so I am going to write this as theta plus pi. Okay, why I wrote like this, I'll write little later, but I'm able to write theta plus pi because within the principal values. Okay, but what is my theta? I started with tan inverse x. So let me write here tan inverse x plus pi. So I got cot inverse 1 by x is equal to tan inverse x plus pi. Bring this pi this side, you got this formula. Okay, so anyway, with the examples, it is better for you to get a feel of it. We already took minus 30, minus 1, minus root 3 and all that. But to write properly the solution, not just verifying for one or two cases, I'm telling this. Basically, you can take x equal to tan theta, so that this will become theta. 1 by tan theta is cot theta, this also will become theta, but you have to check for the principal values. That's why we could not cancel out. The proving this would have been very easy, no? You take x equal to tan theta, this will become theta. Here when you take x equal to tan theta, 1 by tan theta is cot theta, cot inverse cot theta is theta, theta equal to theta proved. But here cot inverse cot theta is not theta because it's not in the principal values. That's why we have to change cot theta as theta plus pi, and we have to write this. And then what we got is this cot inverse 1 by x is this, and we have to bring pi this side to get this formula. Okay. So just for this step, I want to write one thing here, that cot theta plus pi is equal to cot theta, and theta plus pi belongs to, when I add pi here, pi by 2 to pi, which is part of principal values for chord, as long as it is between 0 to pi, can cancel out. Is everybody okay for this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All right. Okay. Please write these things. All of you know, if meeting ends, you will rejoin with the same link.
Yes,
okay, please understand, for all these things we did not write the proof because the proof is so simple. You take x equal to sin theta, LHS will come theta, RHS will come theta. We have to take x as cosecant theta, we'll get theta equal to theta, so proved. You take x equal to cos theta, these two are equal. If you take x equal to secant theta, these two are equal. You take x equal to tan theta, these two are equal. Only when it comes to negative, the principal values has a problem, so we are not able to write directly, so I have a little work there, that's all. Okay, I have to write two more things here. Where I wrote tan in terms of cot, I want to write cot in terms of tan also. Okay, within this fourth one, within this only we can write cot inverse x is tan inverse 1 by x for all x belongs to 0 to infinity. And cot inverse x is equal to tan when x is negative. Anybody want to tell when x is negative how to write cot inverse x in terms of tan inverse 1 by x? Anybody? When x is negative, cot inverse x is tan inverse 1 by x or tan inverse 1 by x plus pi or minus pi or minus tan inverse 1 by x, any such thing. All of you are able to hear me, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yeah, tan inverse 1 by x plus pi.
Yes. Just this minus pi goes this side and 1 by x will become x. So, we'll get tan inverse 1 by x plus pi. Correct. Tan inverse 1 by x plus pi. For all x belongs to minus infinity to 0. One may not need a proof, but if somebody wants to prove, let cot inverse x is equal to theta, then x will be cot theta. And if you want to start with tan inverse 1 by x, it will be tan inverse cot theta. Tan inverse tan theta only. Tan inverse 1 by cot theta, which is tan inverse tan theta. But I cannot cancel tan inverse tan theta and write theta, because theta is not within the principal values of tan. If cot inverse x is theta and x is negative, you have to understand theta belongs to pi by 2 to pi. Because cot principal values are 0 to pi. In that, for positive values, it will give an answer between 0 to pi by 2. For negative values, it will give an answer between pi by 2 to pi. Because between pi by 2 to pi, it is beyond the principal values for tan. I am going to write tan inverse tan. Here I wrote theta plus pi. So here I have to write theta minus pi. Because when I subtract pi, it will be between minus 90 to 0, well within the principal values, which is equal to theta minus pi, since theta minus pi belongs to minus pi by 2 to 0, which is part of the principal values for tan. And here I could change this, because since tan theta minus pi is same as tan theta. I can also write theta plus pi, theta plus 2 pi, but at that time, what I get here will not be principal values for tan. Okay. And now, that theta is cot inverse x minus pi. And you send pi that side, we got a formula. Right. But anyway, with a one or two examples, you can easily understand what is happening. For example, if I take x equal to minus 1, this cot inverse minus 1 is straight away 135. Tan inverse 1 by x is minus 45. What should I add to this to get back 135 is, I have to add 180. That's a plus pi. As simple as that. Or if I take x equal to minus root 3, this is minus 30, this is 150 degrees. This is minus 30. What should I add to get 150 back? Add 180 degrees. So we can easily understand. All right. Okay. Next set of formulas, which are fairly simple. I should have told a little before maybe. Sine inverse minus x is equal to minus sine inverse x. For all, obviously, x belongs to minus 1 to 1. Tan inverse, I'm not writing purposely cos. Tan inverse minus x is minus tan inverse x. This is for all real numbers. For all x belongs to R. Cosecant inverse minus x is equal to minus cosecant inverse x. For all x belongs to minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to infinity. So we have to discuss about cos, secant and tan, cot. If I talk about cos inverse x minus x, it's not minus cos inverse x. So obviously it can't be. Just a minute, Tom. Sorry. Yeah. All these things are no problem because you can, if you want to prove it also very simple, take x equal to sine theta, you look at minus sine theta, sine of minus theta, sine inverse and sine will cancel, look at minus theta, which is minus sine inverse x. Okay, that is very easy to prove. But the only problem with cos is that you take x equal to cos theta, cos inverse minus cos theta, I cannot take this minus inside and write cos inverse cos minus theta. I cannot cancel and write minus theta. There are two problems. First of all, this is not equal to this. Second problem, if theta is between 0 to pi, minus theta is not between 0 to pi. It is between minus pi to 0. It is not within the principal values. Whereas it is, if it is sine, I can take x equal to sine theta here. I will get sine inverse minus sine theta, where theta is between minus 90 to 90. I can take minus inside. Sine inverse sine minus theta. I can cancel this and write minus theta. Why? Because it's within the principal values, and put theta back as sine inverse x. Because sine x is theta, sine theta is x means theta is sine inverse x. Cos is not like that. Okay, this cos inverse minus x equal to minus cos inverse x can't be right because this is between 0 to pi, that is between minus pi to 0. So the formula is actually pi minus cos inverse x. For all x belongs to minus 1 to 1. How to prove this? Let cos inverse x equal to theta, which means x equal to cos theta. And cos inverse x means theta belongs to 0 to pi. Okay, if x is cos theta, let me talk about cos inverse minus x. That will be cos inverse minus cos theta. Cos inverse minus cos theta, I can write cos 180 minus theta or pi minus theta. If theta is between 0 to pi, pi minus theta will be between what to what?
Zero to pi.
When theta is 0, pi minus theta is pi. And when theta is pi, pi minus theta will be 0. So it is within the principal values. And this is equal to this. I can cancel out and write pi minus theta. Since pi minus theta also belongs to 0 to pi. Since pi minus theta belongs to 0 to pi. It is within the principal value, so we can cancel it. So once it is pi minus theta, that is cos inverse minus x equal to pi minus. What is our theta that we started with? Cos inverse x. So this is cos inverse x. We proved it. Okay, I would have told this formula well before because they are so simple. But to prove this, like without example, if I want to prove it, I have to tell the point here that only when there are principal values only you can cancel. Otherwise, you should not cancel. So today morning class, we discussed so many cases where when it is principal values, you can cancel. When it is not principal values, what to do? So that you'll understand these cases better. Okay, everybody clear? First thing is, without even writing solution, why it can't be like these formulas that cos inverse minus x is y not minus cos inverse x? Okay, and why it is only pi minus cos inverse x? You can easily understand with an example if somebody wants. Let me write here. Cos inverse minus x plus cos inverse x is equal to pi. Basically, that's what we've done here. Okay. Let us see how to prove this part. Cos inverse minus x equal to cos inverse x with an example how to understand. When I take x equal to 1 by 2, what is cos inverse 1 by 2?
60.
And cos inverse minus 1 by 2?
120 degrees.
120 plus 60 is 180. When I take x equal to 1 and minus x will be minus 1, what is cos inverse 1?
Zero.
And cos inverse minus 1?
180.
And 180 plus 0 is again 185. Let us I take 1 by root 2. X is 1 by root 2. This will be 45. This will be 135. Again
185. 135.
Yeah. If I take root 3 by 2, this will be 30. This will be 150. Again 180. Okay. So with an example, I can easily, you take a positive example or a negative example, we can prove it. I mean, we can not prove it, sorry, we can verify it. But this is a proper way to prove it, that's all. Ritam Day, are you there? Okay, anybody is not able to follow, please ask me, Alex, if somebody asks.
Yes, sir, I'm there, sir.
Okay, you're able to follow?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So next two formulas are also quite similar in this list. I'm not going to prove them, I'm only going to state them because almost the same proof. So fifth one, secant inverse minus x is minus, no, not minus, sorry, pi minus secant inverse x for all x belongs to minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to infinity. Six, cot inverse minus x is pi minus cot inverse x for all x belongs to everything, all x belongs to R. Okay, so whoever have principal values between minus 90 to 90, no problem, formula is very simple, you can take minus outside. Whoever have principal values 0 to pi, like cos, secant, cot, they have got a different formula. Okay, I'm going to erase this down part at least.
Sir, fourth one wants to say, sir.
Fourth one, I gave enough example. Are you there or you are out in between or something?
No, sir, I was there.
Okay. I gave you some examples like cos inverse of minus x and bring this one this side plus cos inverse,
yes,
x. How it is,
yes,
right? Okay. So with examples, you can get a feel of what is happening and why it, that is why it can't be cos inverse minus x equal to minus cos inverse x. Also, I gave you that this answer is always between 0 to 180. This will be always negative. How can they be equal? Then what,
yes,
is correct?
Sir.
So start with cos inverse x equal to theta. X is cos theta. And when you talk about cos inverse x, your theta will be between 0 to pi. And we are interested in finding cos inverse minus x. In the place of x, you put cos theta. Alright. Now,
yes,
what to do with this minus? Either we have to take it out or take it in. Take it out, we don't have any formula. But taking in minus cos theta, I can write cos 180 minus theta.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, cos inverse and cos, I can cancel and I can write this. Provided, this is within the principal values of cos. And it is. How it is written the principal address of cos? If theta is between 0 to pi, even pi minus theta also will be between 0 to pi only. In fact, when theta is 0, it will be pi. And when theta is pi, it will be 0. So this is also changing between 0 to pi. Anything between 0 to pi, you can cancel cos inverse and write that. And yes. What is theta? Theta is cos inverse x back.
Yes, sir.
All right. Anybody else have still doubt? No. T. Srija, are you able to follow? T. Srija, are you there in the class? Okay. Next set of formulas. Sine inverse x plus cos inverse x is pi by 2. For all x belongs to minus 1 to 1. It's quite interesting in a way. In another way, it is not so interesting. I'll tell you what I mean by it. You take x 0, sine inverse 0 is 0, cos inverse 0 is pi by 2, it will be pi by 2. You take 1 by 2. What is sine inverse 1 by 2?
30 degrees.
And cos inverse 1 by 2?
60 degrees.
The sum will be 90. If we take root 3 by 2, sine inverse 60. Root 3 by 2 is 60, 60 and this is 30. And if we take 1 by root 2, 45 and 45 for that matter. Even if we take 3 by 5, this may be 37, this may be 53. The sum, even if we take negative values, not just positive values, let us take minus 1 by 2. Okay. What is sine inverse minus 1 by 2?
Minus 30 degrees.
And cos inverse minus 1 by 2 is 120.
120
plus 1. Again, it is 90. If I take minus 1 by root 2 and minus 1 by root 2, this is minus 45, that is 135. The sum is 90. With few examples, you can get a feel how it is always 90. So you take any x between minus 9 to 90, positive or negative, minus 1 to 1, positive or negative, it will be pi by 2. You can actually see it. Let us see if somebody can explain this to me. Look at the figure. I'm calling this angle as alpha, this angle as beta, this is x, this is 1, and this is root 1 minus x square. What is alpha in terms of sine inverse or cos inverse or tan inverse? Anybody want to
inverse
x. Sine inverse x, correct. Because sine alpha is x. Okay. What is beta? Anybody want to tell?
Cos inverse x.
Right? Okay. Because cos beta is x, as simple as that. And sum of these angles is 90. That's why sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is 90. Done, right?
Yes.
Okay. But only thing that we cannot prove here is for negative values, we cannot use the triangle. Okay. Okay, so even though it is very simple, it can be proved for positive values. Purposely, I am not writing the solution that I explained. I am going to write a different solution. Let cos inverse x equal to theta. You can also take sin inverse x as theta. Start with something. This means not only x equal to cos theta, your theta belongs to 0 to pi. Now, let me take sin theta. Or let me start with sine inverse x, that is better. Sine inverse x, in the place of x, I can write cos theta. And cos theta, I can write sine 90 minus theta. Can I cancel sine inverse and sine and write pi by 2 minus theta?
Yes, sir.
Yes, because it lies between pi by 2 and minus pi by 2.
Are you sure that this lies between pi by 2 and minus pi by 2?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
When theta is 0, it is pi by 2. When theta is pi, it is minus pi by 2. Okay, so this is equal to pi by 2 minus theta, since pi by 2 minus theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 closed. Whenever theta is between 0 to pi, definitely pi by 2 minus theta will belong to when it is 0, pi plus pi by 2, when it is pi, minus pi by 2. Because it is nicely within the principal values for sine, I am able to cancel it. Okay. Now pi by 2 minus, what is that theta we started with? Cos inverse x. Bring this one here, it done, root. Sine inverse x plus cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2. Okay. So I can explain with examples. You take any number you want. I told you how the sum is 90 degrees. I'm also gave you another explanation of, take a simple right angle triangle. If somebody want to write informally also, you can write that. Take any numbers here for that matter. Take x here, one here, and root 1 minus x square, and this alpha, this is beta. Okay. You can also write alternate solution. The case when x is greater than 0 or x belongs to open interval 0 to 1, this solution is quite valid. Is that cos alpha is equal to x implies alpha equal to cos inverse x. Sine beta is equal to x implies beta equal to sine inverse x. Alpha plus beta equal to pi by 2 implies sine inverse x plus cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2. Proved. Okay. This is a very simple way to prove it. So apart from taking examples, you can prove like this only for positive numbers, but for negative numbers, we have to prove separately. Still, it can be proved. One way is how to prove for negative numbers. If I write x as minus x, cos inverse minus x will be pi minus cos inverse x. I'll get minus sine inverse x minus cos inverse x together will be pi by 2. Pi minus pi by 2 is also pi by 2. Like that, I can prove it. But you've got a feel of it, that's nice. But this we can prove like this. All right. Okay, like this, there are two more formulas where I'm not going to prove it, so that, because I already got a feel of how things are. Next one is obviously secant inverse x plus cosecant inverse x is equal to pi by 2. Or you can write cosecant first and secant next, not a problem. For all x belongs to minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to infinity. This is also true both for negative values and also for positive values. Same thing for tan. Tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equal to pi by 2 for all real numbers. All real numbers for all x belongs to R. Okay, so this first one, I give two proofs. Anybody any doubt about any one of them? No. And these two are almost similar. I'm not writing the proof. Secant inverse x plus cosecant inverse x is pi by 2. In fact, if you replace x with 1 by x there, that formula becomes this. Because sine inverse 1 by x is secant inverse x, so cos inverse is cosecant, whatever. similarly this. But within this third one, I just want to make a note of it here. You can also write tan inverse x plus tan inverse 1 by x is pi by 2. Okay. That is because in the place of cot inverse x, I can write a tan inverse 1 by x. So it is pi by 2. Nothing wrong. But there's a problem. This is only for x greater than 0. For all x greater than 0. What if, you can write below only, but I am writing right side. If I take tan inverse x plus cot inverse x, when x is negative, anybody want to tell what is going to come?
Pi.
Let us say you put minus 1. Put minus 1 here, minus 1 here. What will come? No, not cot inverse x. I am writing cot inverse x, sorry. Tan inverse 1 by x when x is negative.
Minus
1 by x. Yeah.
Sir, unmute.
Okay. Sorry, sometimes my son comes and distracts the class. Okay. He's scolding me. What kind of handwriting you have? Why don't you practice cursive writing books? He's asking. Actually, nowadays we are making him to do. That's why he's written it. Anyway. Tan inverse x plus tan inverse 1 by x. Whenever x is negative, this also negative, this also negative. Their sum will be negative only. If I put, for example, minus root 3, this will be minus 60, this will be minus 30, minus 90. If I put minus 1, minus 45, minus 45, minus 90. Okay, if I put minus root 3, anyway, you can understand that. So it is not pi by 2, rather it is minus pi by 2. For all x less than 0. Okay, so tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is pi by 2 for positive, negative, everything. But when you write tan inverse x plus tan inverse 1 by x, only for positive values it is pi by 2, for negative values it is minus pi by 2. That is because you can also understand another way. What is the formula for cot inverse x in terms of tan inverse 1 by x when x was negative?
Cot inverse x minus pi by 2, minus pi.
Okay. So, because of the tan inverse 1 by x minus pi will come, you'll get pi by 2 minus pi, which is minus pi by 2 kind of thing. So, you can understand. Not a big deal. Okay. Anyway, I discussed the proofs, but at this stage, right now, you know, you're just in the beginning of the lesson. Don't worry about the proof so much. Okay. Take the formula, substitute some x values, get a feel how this sum is 90. You can take x equal to 1 by root 2, root 3 by 2, 1 by root 2. Okay. I would have just told like that in the beginning only. I would have just stated the formulas and I would have told you taking few examples. Okay. I am discussing thoroughly, but for you, two things are important. Remember the formula and getting a feel of the formula by taking some x values. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Okay, now what I am going to write, in another 5 minutes I'll stop. Okay. But what I'm going to write, don't write, just listen and try to answer. Okay. Sine inverse 2x by 1 plus x square. The formula is 2 tan inverse x. Anybody want to tell a proof of this?
Sir, x equals to tan x.
Yeah, simply take x equal to tan theta. Yeah. You take x equal to tan theta, This will become 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan square theta. You will get sin inverse sin 2 theta cancel. You will get 2 theta. Because you took x equal to tan theta, what is your theta will be? Tan inverse x. So you got tan 2 tan inverse x. Done, right? Is it okay for everybody?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Only thing you should know is in trigonometry, the formula that sin 2 theta in terms of tan formula is 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan square theta. You should just remember that only, right? Okay, let us see. If somebody can tell this formula. Tan inverse 3x minus x cube by 1 minus 3x square is equal to what will be the formula? Something like this.
3 tan inverse x.
Yeah. It is 3 tan inverse x. You simply take x equal to tan theta. You will get 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta by 1 minus 3 tan square theta, which is tan 3 theta formula. Tan inverse tan 3 theta, when you cancel tan inverse and tan, you will get 3 theta. And your theta is tan inverse x. So this is actually 3 tan inverse x. Cos inverse 2x square minus 1. Here you took x equal to tan theta. Here also you took x equal to tan theta. Tell me here, should I take x equal to sine?
Cos inverse x.
2 cos inverse x.
Yeah, better to take x equal to cos theta here. Where 2 cos square theta minus 1 is cos 2 theta formula. I will be getting simply cos inverse cos 2 theta and cancel, I will get 2 theta. And theta is back to cos inverse x. That is simply 2 cos inverse x. Chandini, you are able to follow?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next question I'll ask, you should answer, Chandini. Sin inverse 3x minus 4x cube. What do you think answer?
3 sin inverse x.
Somebody change their name to Chandini here. Or they are not here. Just joking, don't.
Sorry, sir.
Chandini, are you there?
Yes, sir.
So what is the answer for sin inverse 3x minus 4x cube?
3 sin inverse x.
Yeah. What should I do it? How to prove it? I have to take x equal to what is the formula for sin 3 theta, Chandani?
Sin x, sir.
What is the formula for sin 3 theta? Sin 3 theta formula is 3 sin theta minus 4 sin cube theta. Based on that, when you take x is equal to sin theta, this will be 3 sin theta minus 4 sin cube theta, which is sin 3 theta. They will cancel. You will be getting sin inverse sin 3 theta. Cancel out, you will get 3 theta. And you can put theta back as sin inverse x. You will get 3 sin inverse x. Like that, you can have many formulas, not a big deal. Okay. For example, cos inverse 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square. What do you think will be the formula?
X will write as tan theta.
2 cos inverse finals. X.
Yeah.
2 tan,
tan theta is right. And the answer is 2 tan inverse. Almost similar, I can write tan inverse 2x by 1 minus x square.
2 tan
inverse
x. That is also 2 tan inverse x. Yeah. So all these three questions are 2 tan inverse x. This is based on sin 2 theta equal to 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan square theta formula. This is based on cos 2 theta equal to 1 minus tan square theta by 1 plus tan square theta formula. This is based on tan 2 theta equal to 2 tan theta by 1 minus tan square theta formula. This is based on cos 2 theta. This is based on sin 3 theta. This is based on tan 3 theta. I'm sure you can now ask. Uday Lakshmi, tell me like this a question, not answer. I'm asking, make a question in terms of cos, what will come?
Sir, cos inverse 4x cube minus 3x.
Answer will be
3 cos inverse x.
3 cos inverse x. Yeah. That's good. Let me ask one more question to anybody can answer. Tan inverse 1 plus x by 1 minus x. Anybody want to guess what will be the answer?
Sir, pi by 4 plus x?
Pi by 4 plus?
Tan inverse x.
Tan inverse x. Yes. It is pi by 4 plus tan inverse x. You simply take x equal to tan theta. 1 plus tan theta by 1 minus tan theta is tan 45 degrees plus theta. Tan inverse and tan will cancel. You will get 45 plus theta and theta is back to tan inverse x. Okay. Let us see who can ask. Sachin Arena, roll number 113. Like this, make a question in terms of sign. Little difficult relatively, but not so difficult. Similar to this, what is the formula I can make in sign?
May I?
Okay, tell.
Sir, sine inverse of 2x root 1 minus x square.
Yes, sine inverse 2x root 1 minus x square is 2 sine inverse
2 x. Sine inverse x.
Yeah. You take x equal to sine theta, you get sine. We want cos, you write root 1 minus x square. That's right. 2 sine theta cos theta, it's fine. Right? Okay. I can write minus here, plus here, and like another formula like minus. Okay? But all the formulas that we discussed just now, okay, all are wrong formulas. What I mean by wrong is they're correct for some x values and they're wrong for some other x values. Okay. Why? It is not that if you have sine inverse sine 2 theta, you can just like that cancel and write 2 theta. You can only do that when 2 theta is
in the principal
values. Okay. So each one of them have actually many answers. For example, sine inverse 2x by 1 plus x square has 3 answers. It is 2 tan inverse x. It is also pi minus 2 tan inverse x. It is also minus pi minus 2 tan inverse x. Okay. Because of the x values. When x is between minus 1 to 1, this formula. After that, we have another formula and all. Why? I can even tell why this formula will be wrong. Okay. I'll tell you obviously why this formula will be wrong. You take x greater than root 3, for example. Why greater than root 3? Greater than 1 by root 3. When x is more than 1 by root 3, tan inverse x answer will be more than
30 degrees.
If this is more than 30, 3 times that will be more than 90. If this is more than 90, tan inverse of something, whatever you take, can the answer be more than 90 degrees?
No, sir.
No. Okay. That means, okay. So right here, I gave you a hint. Okay. Let us see if somebody can tell me this. Let us see. What are the complete set of x values for which this formula is true? We know this formula is true because simply take x equal to tan theta. But what are the x values for which this formula is true? Anybody want to tell an idea? Some idea about it?
Minus 1 by root 3 to 1 by root 3.
Yes, that's good. Very nice. Because 3 tan inverse x has to be between minus 90 to 90. Minus 90 degrees less than 3 tan inverse x less than 90 degrees. Because LHS is between minus 90 to 90. Tan inverse of something, RHS should be that. When you divide with 3, minus 30 degrees less than tan inverse x less than 30 degrees. Only when tan inverse x is between minus 30 to 30, this is valid. And tan inverse x is between minus 30 to 30 means x is between minus 1 by root 3 to 1 by root 3. Only for those values. Okay. So, anyway, this formula is valid for what x values? That is not important at this stage. We need it, but after some days. But at least how this formula is true, you should get a easily feel of that, all the things that I discussed. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
So now it's you'll be able to do your IP exercise also to a major extent, and our mains material also. Maybe if you wait with tomorrow morning class, all the theory mostly will be covered except for 10-20%. Okay. Then we'll discuss the question. So wait for tomorrow's class. After that is over, you can start doing the work. I'll tell you what work to be done. All right.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.